After devouring a pizza, David and Lucas are still hungry and have found some tasty leftovers in the fridge. A pan of brownies, a plate with a stack of raspberry pancakes and chocolate chip pancakes, and a huge sandwich. Of course they will divide all of these equally, but they want to split each item using only one straight cut. Let's start with the brownies. This looks easy except for one issue. Using a rectangular form, Lucas's grandfather cut out a piece, leaving a gaping hole. How can the guys divide the remaining brownies equally with just one cut? Without the hole, any cut through the center of the rectangle would work. The key now is to cut through the center of the brownies and the center of the hole. The brownies in the hole are both equally divided, so David and Lucas get the same amount of brownies. Let's move on to the pancakes. While each guy has his own preference for either raspberries or chocolate chips, they see it as a challenge to divide each stack of pancakes equally with a single cut. For a fixed angle, there are many ways to cut the raspberry pancakes, but only one way which leaves the same amount on the right as on the left. If we extend the line to cut the chocolate chip pancakes, however, there is clearly more on the left than on the right. If we rotate the line slightly and adjust it so that the raspberry pancakes are still bisected, we split the chocolate chip pancakes a little more evenly. If we rotate the line too much, now the second stack is unbalanced the other way. There is an angle in between which divides both stacks of pancakes perfectly. Dividing the ham sandwich is a little more delicate. With one slice, Lucas and David want to divide the top piece of bread, the meat, and the bottom piece of bread each in half. A similar argument as that used for the pancakes does the job here. Such a division is easier to see if the three objects are spheres. The plane going through the center of the spheres divides each sphere equally in half. The ham sandwich replaces the spheres with more complicated objects, but the intuition is the same. All of these divisions are special cases of the ham sandwich theorem. Yeah, it's really called that. The theorem says that if you have n objects in n-dimensional space, there is an n-1 dimensional plane which divides each of the n objects in half. The pancakes and brownies are just special cases with n equals 2, while the sandwich works with n equals 3. The ham sandwich theorem is powerful, but we understand if some people are too distracted to appreciate it.